Hi students, welcome back. Today I am discussing certain problems related to rotational dynamics. Our first question: a three particle system consists of masses m1 equal to 4 kg, m2 equal to 2 kg and m3 is equal to 3 kg. Placed at the points A 231, B 222 and C 321. The coordinates of the center of mass of this system is, we want to find out the center of mass of the system. Okay, we know that position coordinate of the center of mass. Okay, equation for the position coordinate of center of mass, that is xCM equal to m1x1 plus m2x2 plus m3x3 divided by m1 plus m2 plus m3, m1 plus m2 plus m3. Okay, because this is a three particle system, xCM is equal to m1 x1 plus m2 x2 plus m3 x3 divided by m1 plus m2 plus m3. Okay, we know that m1 is equal to 4 kg, m2 is equal to 2 kg and m3 is equal to 3 kg. Okay, then m1, what about m1? 4 into x1. Okay, x1 is 2. Okay, this one is x1, here y1 and this one is z1. B coordinate represents x2, y2, z2. Okay, and C coordinate represents x3, y3, z3. Okay, so we can substitute the values. M1 is equal to 4. 4 into x1 is equal to 2 plus m2 is equal to 2. 2 into x2 is equal to 2 plus m3 is equal to 3 kg. 3 into, what about x3? x3 is equal to 3. Okay, 3 divided by, the whole divided by 4 plus 2 plus 3. Okay, that's equal to 8 plus 4 plus 9. Okay, 8 plus 4 plus 9. 8 plus 4 plus 9 is equal to 21. Okay, 8 plus 8, 16, 17, 17 plus 4. That's equal to 21. 21 divided by 4 plus 2, 8. 8 plus 3 is equal to 11. Okay, 21 divided by 11. That's the coordinate. Okay, x coordinate is equal to center of mass of x is equal to xCM is equal to 21 divided by 11. Okay, similarly we can find out what about yCM. Okay, yCM is equal to m1y1 plus m2y2 plus m3y3 divided by, the whole divided by m1 plus m2 plus m3. Okay, what about m1? M1 is equal to 4. 4 into y1. y1 is equal to 3 plus m2 equal to 2. 2 into y2. y2 is equal to 2 plus m3. m3 is equal to 3. 3 into y3. y3 is equal to 2. The whole divided by 4 plus 2 plus 3. That's equal to 11. Equal to 4 into 3, that is 12, plus 4 plus 6, 12 plus 4 plus 6, that's equal to 22, 22 divided by 11, 22 by 11 is the second coordinate, 22 by 11 is equal to 2, okay, 2, then the second coordinate, yCM is equal to 2. And what about ZCM? ZCM is equal to, ZCM is equal to M1 Z1 plus M2 Z2, M2, okay, into Z2 plus M3 Z3 divided by M1 plus M2 plus M3. That's equal to 4 into 1. Z1 is equal to 1. Plus M2. M2 is equal to 2. 2 into 2 is 2. Z2 is equal to 2. Plus M3, 3 into Z3, Z3 is equal to 1. The whole divided by 4 plus 2 plus 3, that is 11. Equal to 4 plus 4 plus 3. Okay, 11 divided by 11. 4 into 1, 4. 2 into 2, 4. 4 plus 4 is equal to 8. 8 plus 3 is equal to 11. 11 by 11 is equal to 1. Okay, then what about the coordinate of the center of mass? The coordinate of the center of mass of the system is equal to 21 by 11, 2, 1. Okay, center of mass of the coordinate system. Okay, here we can write center of mass of the coordinate system is 21 by 11, 2, 1. Okay, our second question. A system consists of two particles A and B of masses in the ratio 2:3. A moves along positive direction of x axis with a velocity 20 meter per second. A moves along the positive x direction of x axis with a velocity 20 meter per second, and B moves along the negative direction of y axis with a velocity 10 meter per second. Okay. Then velocity at the center of mass of the system is, we want to find out the velocity at the center of mass. Okay. In the question, it is very clear that A moves along the positive direction of x axis and B moves along the negative direction of y axis. So what about the velocity at the center of mass? Velocity at the center of mass, we see m, that is equal to m1 v1 plus m2 v2 divided by m1 plus m2. This is the equation to find out the velocity at the center of mass. Okay, that's equal to m1. M1 is equal to 2, 2 into 2m, or we can take it as 2. 2 into, what about V1? V1 is equal to 10 meter per second along the x axis. Positive direction of x axis, that is 10, okay, 20 meter per second, okay. What about V1? V1 is equal to 20 meter per second along the positive direction of x axis, that is 20i plus M2. M2 is equal to 3M or 3. Okay. 3 into what about V2? V2 is equal to B moves along the negative direction of y axis with a velocity 10. Okay. 10 into minus J. Negative direction of y axis. The whole divided by 2 plus 3. That's equal to 5. Then what about the answer? It's equal to 40i minus 30j, 40i minus 30j divided by 5. Okay, that's equal to 8i minus 6j. 8i minus 6j is the velocity of the center of mass. Okay. Velocity of the center of mass is given by m1 v1 plus m2 v2 divided by m1 plus m2. M1, that's equal to 2, and v1 is equal to 20i. M2 is equal to 3, v2 is equal to 10 into minus j, because it is moving along the negative direction of y axis. Okay. Then a 40i minus 30j divided by 5, that's equal to 8i minus 6j. Okay. Our next question. A system consists of two particles A and B of masses 1 kg and 2 kg. The force acting on them are 10 newton and 20 newton. The acceleration of the center of mass is. We want to find out acceleration of the center of mass. Okay. Equation for the acceleration of center of mass, ACM, that is equal to M1 A1 plus M2 A2 divided by M1 plus M2. Okay, here the system consisting of two particles, so acceleration of the center of mass is equal to M1 A1 plus M2 A2 divided by M1 plus M2. Here, A1 and A2 are not given, but forces are given. Okay, mass into acceleration is equal to force. So we can write instead of M1 A1 as F1, F1 plus instead of M2 A2 that's equal to F2 divided by total mass, that is M1 plus M2. That's equal to, what about F1? Forces acting on the mass 10 Newton and 20 Newton. Okay, then 10 plus 20 divided by M1. M1 is equal to 1 kg and M2 is equal to 2 kg, 1 plus 2. That's equal to 30 divided by 3, it's equal to 10. Okay, 10 meter per second square, 10 meter per second square, that is the acceleration of the center of mass of the system. Okay, equation for the center of mass is equal to acceleration of the center of mass is equal to M1 A1 plus M2 A2 divided by M1 plus M2. Okay, our next question, two point masses M and 4M are separated by a distance of 10 meter. Okay, two masses M and 4M. M and 4M. Which are separated by a distance of. Okay, from the center of the first body to the center of the second body. It's equal to 10 meter. Okay, if they start moving under the action of their internal forces, then they will collide at a distance of. Okay, at what distance? Okay, from given mass small m, they collide. Or from what distance from the mass 4m, it collide. Okay, we want to find out that. Suppose this is the point where they collide. Okay, then we can take that point as the center of mass of the system. Then we can write XCM. XCM is equal to M1 X1 plus M2 X2 divided by M1 plus M2. If we consider the center of mass is at the origin. Okay, if we consider the center of mass as the origin, XCM is taken as 0. 0 equal to M1. M1 is equal to M. And what about the distance from M to the center of mass? That is taken as X. Okay, this distance is taken as X. Okay, that is X. Then what about M2? M2 is equal to 4M. And what about X2? X2 is taken as. Okay, what about X2? X2 is taken as 10 minus X. Okay, from the center of mass to 4m, that is taken as 10 minus x. Okay, if it is positive, from here to here, if it is positive, from the center of mass to 4m, if it is taken as, the distance is taken as, or displacement is taken as positive, then what about the distance x from center of mass to this? Okay, what about this distance, that is taken as minus x. Okay, so we can write m into minus x, so there will be a negative sign, plus 4m into 10 minus x, the whole divided by m1 plus m2, that is m plus 4m. Okay, here x is taken as negative, that is measurement is from center of mass to m. Okay, that is taken as negative, then center of mass to 4m, that is taken as positive, that is 10 minus x. From here we can write m into x is equal to 4m into 10 minus x. Okay, then mx is equal to 40m minus 4mx. Okay, then 5mx is equal to 5mx on rearranging, 5mx is equal to 40m. M get cancelled, then 5x is equal to 40, then x is equal to 40 divided by 5, that's equal to 8. Okay, 8 meter is the distance from the small m mass, okay, from the mass m to the center of mass. Okay, small x is equal to 8 meter. That's the answer. Okay, in this question, we want to find out the distance. To find out the distance, we can use the center of mass equation xam is equal to m1 x1 plus m2 x2 divided by m1 plus m2. Okay, suppose if these two bodies collide at the center of mass, then we can draw an axis here at the center of mass. Okay, and that axis which is taken as the origin. So, xam is equal to 0. Then, on substituting the value of m1, x1 and m2, x2, we got the answer as 8 meter. Okay, our next question. If Earth is considered as a uniform solid sphere of radius capital R and mass small m, rotating with an angular velocity omega, the rotational kinetic energy of the Earth is. We want to find out the kinetic energy, rotational kinetic energy of the Earth is. Okay, we know the equation for the rotational kinetic energy, kinetic energy rotation, that is equal to half I omega square. Okay, I is the moment of inertia. What about the moment of inertia of a solid sphere? Here, Earth is considered as a uniform solid sphere. Then, instead of moment of inertia I, we can substitute the value of moment of inertia of solid sphere. Okay, then it's equal to half into moment of inertia of solid sphere is equal to 2 by 5 mr square into omega square. Then 2 get cancelled. The final answer is 1 by 5 mr square omega square. Okay, this is the kinetic energy or rotational kinetic energy of the Earth. Okay, our next question. A disk of mass capital M and radius capital R is shown in the figure. Okay, this is the disk which is having a mass capital M and radius capital R. If it rotates about an axis passing through the point P, this disk is rotates about an axis which is passing through the point P. Okay, on its circumference and perpendicular to the plane of the disk. The moment of inertia of the disk about an axis of rotation is. We want to find out what about the moment of inertia of the disk about an axis which is passing through the point P. Okay, here we know that the axis which are passing through O and P. Okay, we can draw just like this. This is the circular disk. This is the center of mass of the system O. Axis which is passing just like this. Okay, passing perpendicular to the plane of the disk and through the center of mass. And another point P which is on the circumference of the disk and the axis which is passing through is just like this. What about these two axes? These two axes are parallel to each other, so we can apply parallaxis theorem. According to parallaxis theorem, moment of inertia about any axis which is equal to ICM, moment of inertia about the center of mass, plus M into A square. Okay, what about moment of inertia about the center of mass of this disk? We know that equation mr square divided by 2. Moment of inertia about an axis passing through the center of mass of the disk is equal to mr square divided by 2 plus m into, what about A? A is the distance between the two axes. Distance between the two axes, that is taken as capital R. R is the radius. So, A is equal to capital R. Then on substituting A square, that's equal to R square, we can write mr square by 2 plus mr square, that's equal to 3 by 2 mr square. Okay, then moment of inertia about an axis passing through the point P is equal to 3 by 2 mr square. Okay, I think these questions are clear for you. If you like this video, please subscribe and enable the bell button. Thank you.